request Dr. M. Vijay Kumar to felicitate the awardee with the traditional shawl. Rahman, sir, I request you to deliver the acceptance speech.
There are many moments in life where you get embarrassment. Maybe the first night of wedding. Nowadays this is not going to happen now. And an 81-year-old man sitting like a bridegroom getting all these things is something very unusual. Thanks for giving the opportunity to receive this award. It's a privilege and honor to receive this award, which was given to many eminent personalities in the past. And grateful to Mangalore Management Association for selecting me for this year's prestigious award. It is Vishwanath Kamath, myself and Father Ronnie Prabhu. We started an organization here as Communal Harmony. And that was the area where we thought of bringing all people together for harmonious living in these districts. Vishwanath Kamath was secretary. I am the secretary of Muslim organization. There was another secretary also from the Christian side. Of course, that particular is very important because that is what is relevant now. I am also feeling, because of Vishwanath Kamath's initial feeling of that necessity of this award to recognize the achievers or excellent managers, which is a part of my emotion also. Management is very important for human excellence. Efficient management is required right from home to industry, to schools, to colleges, to universities, to societies in the nation and the world at large. I keep participating in management related programs from the very beginning. I must congratulate all of you who are actively involved in promoting management program in Mangalore. Leaders and management are like the object and its shadow. Wherever there is a shadow, there is an object behind it. And there is also a light behind the object which gives the shadow. Management is the shadow. Leadership is the object. There is no management without proper leadership. Leadership denotes vision, direction, focus, target, etc. Whereas management is the one that paves the way towards achieving the target or reaching the destination. Whatever I have been doing or what all you have been seeing as my management efficiency, I come out of the clarity of my vision. The clarity of vision always to meet the needs of the society at any particular time. In the early days, when he started the hospital, I had a vision to have best of healthcare, what is best in the world, not available in our local area. That is how originally conceived Unity Hospital. Also, we have an excellent vision of what is required. There are three facets of healthcare delivery system. They are, one is the prevention of diseases, second is the promotion of health, and the third is cure of the diseases. Doctors and hospitals yesterday and today are mostly focused on third, which is cure alone is the remedy. The prevention of diseases and promotion of health was ignored. In the late year 1970, I visualized hospital with a comprehensive healthcare system where the prevention of diseases and promotion of health along with advanced diagnosis and therapy are integrated as a comprehensive healthcare service system. This was a great challenge work to initiate at that time. These are being done by the government and medical colleges now, not at that time. When I approve the ministers say comprehensive health care, we want to do in the hospital, we don't have such thing in our government system. That's the reply I got from the health minister. Now every college, every government is more focusing on prevention of diseases and promotion of health. My favorite author, Peter Drucker, known as father of modern management, says management originally started being business management. Then it went into corporations, it went into organization in different levels. And now management has started from home. Mother being the first naturally inherent manager. Everyone experienced that. Best manager, best wife. We see in many families, mother manages everything, cooking to managing house, including managing her husband. This is the natural management seen in human beings. Now we are reached a stage where humanity requires an emergency management system for the earth. Survival of the individuals are our concern of the hospital. Survival of humanity is the greatest challenge. We need to take up several corrective measures. Leadership today should focus on what we call emergency management of planet Earth. There is an unseen management which is visible or evident in the whole of the universe. We call this management by natural law. To illustrate, once I was staying in a hotel in Mumbai. As I was sitting and relaxing in the balcony, I saw a large number of birds busy eating on the ground. Some people used to put some rice and other things there. So the birds used to come and enjoy their delicious eatables. Suddenly, somebody took a stone and threw on these birds. All birds start flying at one. Instantly they start flying and they all flew away side by side in a crowd without touching each other. If it is a similar pattern, number of planes are grounded on emergency takeoff instantly, like the bird. We are sure they all will crash. What does this happen? What does this mean? Management by natural law, like birds, are subject to safety, whereas management by human beings are subject to accident. The natural law is with safety, security, and prosperity. Birds fly together, fishes swim together. Even ants move together in groups, in harmony. Human beings are also moved together. They are the most intelligent animals you could see. But they are the only species who kills the fellow species. When we follow the truth, we follow the natural law like birds. Mahatma Gandhi, the only person I understood who had written his biography as my experiment with truth. He was focusing on truth. Who are part of the governing system in the world should align themselves with the principle of truth for survival on the planet Earth. My request to you all is to start a new institute of leadership and management. We can name this as Mangalore Institute of Leadership and Management.
Thank you, sir. You narrated leadership and management so beautifully, and thank you for the acceptance.